Mr. Federal, I'm here to share with you something on clearing and forwarding, and more so the topic today, as you can see, on the screen, is about cargo consolidation and the consolidation. Now, the objectives which we have for this topic, one of the objectives is you are required that by the end of the lesson, you as a learner, you need to be able to explain the meaning of cargo consolidation, explain the meaning of cargo deconsolidation, explain the purpose of consolidation and deconsolidation, explain the concept of packing and handling of cargo, explain the process of consolidation and deconsolidation, analyze the quality in cargo consolidation and deconsolidation, and discuss the practitioners in cargo consolidation. Also, to state and explain the cargo consolidation and deconsolidation documents. And next, state and explain the cargo consolidation and deconsolidation. And lastly, analyze the safety and the security measures in cargo consolidation and deconsolidation. So this is what you are required to know. And straight away, as you can see on your screen there, I'll try to elaborately define what cargo consolidation is. That is a freight consolidation. Freight consolidation is simply it is the process. It is the process. The practice of shipping multiple smaller shipments, likely headed to a similar destination, as one cohesive shipment for the purpose of reducing the economic and ecological impact of that particular shipment. That is the economic impact. Here we talk about this cost saving. That is the economic impact we're talking about here. The ecological impact here, we are talking about when we have several trucks or ships moving along the way in the sea, on there's that pollution of the environment. Okay, yeah. So that is what it is trying to save us from, that ecological impact, the impact it will have in our environment. Okay, then also consolidation means shippers get to pay bulk rates. Bulk rates, since they are shipping cargo at all the same time, instead of sending a lot of smaller shipments. So, if you were to be charged, maybe let's say that shipment is supposed to be charged maybe 50,000. Okay, and you are three of you now. What do you do here? Being that now you are three, each party here is going to contribute. Depending on the space which your cargo is taking, you will not pay the entire 50. So you see, on that alone, it is saving. Sorry, it is helping you to save the bulk rate. So it is a fantastic option for shippers who only have a few pallets of a product or smaller shipments. They want to package and ship in one container. So it's a cheap option. See that? So that is what consolidation simply means. So in short, consolidation, we're talking about consolidation. You bring whatever you have, I bring whatever you have, then we go to a consolidator. He give us space where we are heavy, then we make what called the other term we call the LCLs. They are called LCL containers. Okay. Yeah. So that is less than container load. And when this happens now, the shipper, sorry, the consolidator or the freight forwarder will issue the shipper with what we call house bill of lading as an evidence that there is a contract between you and him. Remember, in consolidation, the contract is not between the ship and the shipping line, as in many cases, but the contract is between the ship and the consolidator, either freshwater or an NVOCC. But now, the freight forwarder has a contract. For the freight forwarder, he has a contract of carriage with the shipping line. So the shipping line with the issue of freight forwarder, what we call a master PL. Okay? Yes. Now, on the other hand, we have what called deconsolidation. What is deconsolidate? The act of separating out LCL's shipment to prepare them for final delivery to Shafika. No, sorry. We have reached the final port of destination. So party A, party B, party C. Okay? So we break that LCL so that party A, cargo is kept this side, party B, the cargo is kept this side, and all that. So LCL shipment are consolidated into a container at origin and deconsolidated at destination. So it is just the opposite of consolidating. Consolidating, you're bringing them together. Deconsolidating, you're now separating them. But okay, so that's all that means. Okay. Then, so it can be, or can also call it the breaking the bulk. Okay, deconsolidation is the same as the breaking the bulk, making the bulk into smaller segments. Okay. The destination port. Now, purpose of cargo consolidation. Why do we do the consolidation? Remember, we can consolidate for it to be carried by either truck, we can consolidate for it to be carried by a ship, we can consolidate for it to be carried by air. Okay, so one reason is that it helps in reducing shipping cost. And as you can see, that we say the first and most readily obvious benefit of freight consolidation is the cost reduction. Right? Rates for the LTL there, that's the less than truckload, that is, if it is carried in a network, a container that is carrying shipments belonging to different shippers on the truck, or an LTL, less than container load, that is, if it is carried in a ship. Vary depending on the size of the shipment. However, if your shipment only fills a sixth of a truck, you'll have to pay. You'll have to pay for the full truck at the current static rate customary for the that sort of shipment. You will not tell them that. I have a less, but the distance remains the same. The fuel remains the same. The crew remains the same. So you have to bear that. But remember, when each party has got a small, then you'll find that at the end of the day, the cost is going to be cheap. Okay? Then also, that is reduce damage to freight. There's that jottling around when, like, the entire container has a sixth of your consignment. When the truck is moving, the cargo will keep on hitting here and there, and that one can cause breakages at the final port of destination. So when this happens now, then you find that it is another damage which maybe you didn't insure them. So. But when they are consolidated together to the consolidation and they are packed together, then that impact is going to be reduced. There will be no less damage. Okay. So it can also help in reducing damage to freight because of the compactness when they are shipped together. Another thing is lower fuel emission and expenditure. Now, it is said that along with the reducing cost by saving on fuel, using fewer trucks ultimately result in less fuel emission. Rather than shipping three small shipments in three trucks, a shipper may use one truck for all the three ships. Fatherless father helps to reduce the effect of fuel consumption on the environment. Yeah. You decide maybe you have three trucks, so this one carry half. At the end of the day, you use a lot of fuel. You die, you also cause a lot of air pollution in the environment. That is it. So it is not effective. Yeah. Then streamlined transit is another point there. You see there, the streamlined transit. Now, the nature of the retail in today's economy demand short transit times and even shorter lead times. Now, a lead time is that time between order and delivery. Okay? The time it takes between when you order and when you get whatever you order. So, faithful consolidation, shippers are able to streamline the speed of transit. Since the majority of freight being shipped using freight consolidation is headed to the same direction. So, the time required for shipping is drastically reduced in this way. Consolidation freight acts increasing like a TL, that is a truckload, a full truckload shipment, which goes straight from shippers to receivers without no stop in between. Remember this, when they say the entire ship is carrying the consolidated cargoes, it will not have a port to maybe stoppage. There's no stoppage because the stoppage there is at the port of destination. And we cannot consolidate where one container is being opened in two different ports. No. It will be open in one port. So if this one can also help in streamlining the transit time. Okay? Then avoid order overcrowded docks. When you consolidate multiple shipments into one truck, naturally means that less trucks will be used. Having a dock that is overcrowded with the trucks creates another problem for shippers, ranging from late shipment to unattended detention times, which is an extra cost. So additionally, the drivers will also appreciate this streamlined approach because they will have to less wait time eating into their own service. Yeah. So freight consolidation is equal to less truck and also the same as more frequency as well as total. It also enables the adoption of new technology. It is said that it has never been easier to execute the consolidation process than it is now. And this is thanks to advances in technologies. Many organizations use inventory softwares and have triggers in place that automatically notify a system when an order is more of a product using automated inventory counting system. So additionally, the STM system will often review scheduled loads with parameters important such as now anything having positives do not miss negative challenges